Today we're on Fripp Island at the Fripp Island Golf and Beach Resort, Fripp Island, South Carolina. So doing something a little different. This is a private island. There's just one bridge on and off. You have to go through a guard shack, which you see right there. So you have to be either a property owner, a guest, or in our case, renters to get on this island. You can't even get on the island to just drive around and explore. So you rent houses. It's kind of like an Airbnb type situation. We went with another family, so this was the house that they rented. This here is the house that we rented. And I'll show you a little bit of both, obviously more of the one we were in. But there's houses, and there's also, you can rent condos. Some of the condos are as small as a standard hotel room. So there's a lot of variety of different properties you can rent here. Ours came with a golf cart, which is very important because that's pretty much the mode of transportation around here is golf carts. So I would make sure you have one with your rental. This is the house that the other family rented. A little bit more modern, kind of a nicer house in my opinion. The one we had was a little more rustic, but it did have a living room with plenty of seating, a dining room area, outside patio. It was two stories. I had a full kitchen, so you got stove, oven, microwave, two coffee makers, one was a Keurig, full refrigerator, had pots, pans, utensils, everything, TV with cable, had Wi-Fi in the house. They even left us plenty of games. It does come with linen, so you have sheets, pillowcases, pillows, towels. There was a few supplies if you needed a little something for cooking, vacuum cleaner for cleanup. But everything else you pretty much need to bring in. This is a little outside screen porch that was there. Here's one of the bedrooms. So it was three bedrooms. There was a bedroom with two bunk beds, another bedroom with two bunk beds and a queen. And then we had another bedroom with just a queen. Like I said, golf carts are the primary mode of transportation. So many rentals come with it, a golf cart. There are places to rent, but you gotta be really careful because the other family rented one from a rental place. The day we got there, their reservation was, you know, they didn't have any carts, so they had to wait another whole day before they could get their golf cart. Again, golf carts are the primary mode of transportation here on the island. There is a rec center, which you see a flyer there, or not a flyer, banner, advertising events. A lot of lagoons and little ponds and marshes and swamps. You gotta be very careful because those are full of alligators. So definitely you gotta watch the alligator situation here on Fripp Island. So if you're gonna swim in the pools or swim in the beach. This is a general store that's up front. You definitely wanna try to get your supplies before you get on the island. It's about a half hour back to Beaufort before any bigger stores like Walmart or things like that. This little general store, there was a gift shop. There's actually a real estate office. You can also rent these little cars too to run around the island. But the general store had quite a bit of stuff. Had shirts and souvenirs, you know, beverages, beer, wine. There was a liquor store adjacent next door, chips, snacks, actually even a little snack bar back there where you could order sandwiches. That you don't need an amenity card, and I'll mention more about amenity cards in a minute. This is the marina. The marina, you can buy gas, although I would recommend filling up off the island because it's about a dollar more a gallon to fill up on the island. But there's a restaurant, there's excursion trips you can take, and a second little store. This is a little bit smaller store, also has a little deli you can get sandwiches. There are plenty of parks around the island that are open with playground equipment, basketball hoops, volleyball courts, lots of things to do. Now, everything you've seen so far except for the restaurants, anybody can go to. This is how you reserve. Go to the Fripp Island Resort website. You can rent properties on there. You also can go to some of the Airbnb type of sites too. But when you get there, you're going to go to the office. You're going to get this little guide. If you rented through the resort, tells you about all the areas on the island, dining options. Now, I'll talk about dining option, and I'm going to show you the key to coming to this island. You got to have pretty much an amenity card. And how that works is the owners of the properties that you're renting belong to the club. Club membership gets them access to all the amenities on the island, most all the amenities. So you got to have these cards here to pretty much do anything on the island except for going to the stores and, you know, going to the beach. Our house had a little kind of a guide, told you about check-in, what to do at check-out. They want, you know, they wanted the sheets taken off the bed and everything thrown on the bed. Towels, they wanted all piled up in front of the washer and dryer downstairs. So it tells you what to do, what to set the temperature on. There's a food court, which really wasn't that great. Truck stop food courts are 10 times better, but you need an amenity card to go there. You need an amenity card to go to that pool. You need an amenity card to go to the Cabana Club and come to this pool. This is a heated pool, the only heated pool on the island. There are several swimming pools like this one. These are not heated. This was April, so the ice water was really cold. So obviously the more popular pool was the heated pool. Most of the pools are locked. You have to have the amenity card to get in, so you could maybe slip an extra person in with you that doesn't have an amenity card. But the more popular pools, there are people there checking cards. Each individual age 13 and over has to have an amenity card to go to any of the amenities on the island. Lots of wildlife. The deer are very tame. You can pretty much walk up to them. Lots of beach access. You don't need an amenity card to go to the beach. You can park your golf cart right by the access. Beautiful beaches. Probably the best thing about this whole trip was the beaches, because they're gorgeous beaches and they are not that crowded because it's not open to the public. You have to either live, be a guest, or rent on the island to access any of these beaches. So definitely that's the biggest part of the trip that was worth it, is having these great beaches with not very many people on it. Watch out for jellyfish. There were a lot of jellyfish. Some of the things in our unit, there was light bulbs missing, cracked ceilings, broken stairs. It wasn't that clean. If this was a hotel, I would have definitely complained about the cleanliness. That's one of the downfalls of doing Airbnb type places, is you're kind of at the mercy of the people that are cleaning it. Absolutely no recycling at all on this island, which disappointed me for all the people living here. Because look at this beautiful view. This is a great place. They should recycle and take care of it. Even the garbage trucks that come to the houses were just one truck and everything got thrown together. But great place to come and check out. Definitely recommend it.